Hello, everyone. Welcome to Unwrapping Complexity, the Python for Rhino and Grasshopper Intermediate course in collaboration with MIL Live Academy. My name is Vincenzo Reale, and I'm an architect and structural engineer. During the last 10 years, I've worked with many different architectural and design firms, such as Tom Wiscombe Emergent Architecture, Dadid Architect. I'm currently working for Arup in London. I've always been passionate about parametric design, and I've had many collaborations with different designers, architects, and engineers trying to apply parametric technique to the development of various and different designs. The advent of computational techniques fully integrated into design tools has allowed for exceptional improvement in automation, speed, and optimization. Most importantly, it has allowed designers to harness complexity and embed intricate logics to enrich their design. So during this course, I want to explore with you the potential of Python coding language applied to the generation of parametric design. During this seminar, by looking at examples from the natural world, we will show how complexity can be explored, decomposed into simple parts, scaled and manipulated, employing the potential for the generation of novel design outcomes through scripting. We will look at natural examples that have an intrinsic high degree of complexity, and we'll try to translate that into real designs through coding approach. So this is the outline of the seminar. After a brief overview of the Python language and its application within Rhino 3D and Grasshopper, we will focus on the exploration of the powerful inbuilt geometry types within Rhino: NURBS, curves, surfaces, as well as meshes. Through a series of structured workflows, for which I will provide you codes that we will explore and understand together, and through the use of the different Python libraries, I will show you how the properties of these geometries can be leveraged to produce field of interaction, reactive components, aggregation, and proliferation, accomplishing the generation of different and elaborate design. I will keep the seminar as interactive as possible, trying to challenge your skill as well as allowing for a customization of your outcomes. Instead, we will start building upon the basic blocks of Python in order to generate initial aggregation. We will then move to more complex geometry generation and manipulation by making use of the power of the inbuilt geometry types, as well as the interaction that we can generate within Python coding. So here you can see, for example, a very simple force field generated by just using randomly aggregated points and vectors. I would like to show you how easy is it to code interaction logic within Python and embed them in a super component. This is one simple example that I will show you during the course to show the manipulation of curve and vectors can be easily achieved, and different results can be obtained just by tweaking a few parameters. And of course, the results can always be embedded and disseminated throughout different techniques. Moving from here, we will look on how surfaces can be addressed, tessellated, populated with components in a way which is much, much more complex than the usual simple tessellation that are already available with Grasshopper. Through the techniques that I will show you during the course, you will see how easily you can escalate complexity in order to generate novel design by just applying those simple rules to a much different and variegated aggregations of components. We will then go back to the generation of aggregation and try to customize them even more. We will try to achieve is like a base canvas on top of which we could build different layers of complexity. So here you can see an example of a workshop that we will learn during the course. This is a base geometry that I have generated and then simplified just for the sake of this example, but generated through Python. For example, what I want to teach you during this day is how you can take this geometry and paint yourself on this geometry. Allow and embedding information into the geometry yourself just by deciding where you want to have particular effects on your geometry and on your mesh. And then blending this information. And then once the information is embedded into geometry, how can you actually make use of Python, a very simple Python component, in order to read that information? Remember that the color doesn't need to be something that you have painted on, but it could also come from information from other software or the environment within which the mesh is immersed. And just by running simple script, you could make use of that information and start generating and differentiating the surface treatment of that geometry by reading specific information that you have somehow encoded. By unwrapping the complexity of the processes that we will look about today, it will be shown how science can ultimately be liberated from the constraints of the tools, allowing for the free flow of creativity and allow for tackling the high degree of complexity and beauty that can be seen in natural forms. I'm really looking forward to having you in this course, and I'm excited to see the great designs you will be able to generate with the technique I will teach you.